Thank you for everything that's come before you. Lord, as we come before your people with your word, Lord, we pray, Lord, in this Christ's word, our mouth. Give us what to say and how to say it, Lord. You will edify, it will touch. It will help to encourage. Lord, if you have to rebuke, so be it, Lord Jesus Christ. But help us, Lord. Lord, even when we're found in the word, help us, Lord, to submit ourselves. To be first partaker, Lord, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, praise God. God is good.
Hallelujah. Yes, He is.
And, you know,
yes, He is.
The old year is already gone.
Yes, sir.
And you know, there are certain things in our life that we really don't have control over.
Amen.
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 You know, if your job decides to cut positions, you don't have any control over that.
No, sir, you don't.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So certain things, but amen, if another person decides to act crazy, you don't have control over that, so to speak,
amen,
to a certain extent.
Amen.
But one thing you do have control over is what comes out of your mouth.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. What comes out of your mouth? Amen. If you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart. Amen.
Amen.
Just as though an act of faith, one of the acts of faith is confession with your mouth.
Yes.
And you believe in your heart.
Amen.
So is, amen, the things that come out of us.
Amen.
Are either going to make us or they're going to break us.
Amen.
Yes.
You hear what I'm saying? They're either going to make us or they break us.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. If you look, one thing that Joshua had, he was able to galvanize the people. Mm-hmm. The words that came out of his mouth were inspiring.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
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 God gave him that ability because he was going to lead the people.
Yes.
And even Moses, with all his excuses, well, I'm slow of speech. Well, somehow. When he said, let's go forth, the people went forth.
Amen.
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 When he spoke the word and said, stand still and see the salvation of God. Amen. Guess what? God made a way for the people.
Amen.
Amen. So we realize, saints, amen, if we're going to, amen, be honest with ourselves. Mm-hmm. The world is so concerned with what it puts inside of the body.
Yes.
And there's nothing wrong with that.
That's right.
Because excess of anything is not good for you.
That's true.
Amen. But you know, you got these people in the world that, amen, they'll eat healthy this and organic that. At the end of the day, they'll roll up a marijuana cigarette.
That's true.
And smoke it.
That's true.
Or they'll do other things that are a little bit more hardcore in Jesus' name.
That's right.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. It's always amazing to me.
Yes, sir.
Amen. We're always so concerned about, amen, the outward appearance.
Yes.
But the more important thing, what's going on the inside?
Yes.
And as we come and as we embark on this year 2000,
yes, sir,
one thing final, we need to learn to think before we speak in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Very important. Are you going to be a person that encourages? Or are you going to be a person that breaks down a discourse? God want to know, are you going to change? Are you going to endeavor to do better? Amen. Or are you going to be the same person? Are you going to continue to cut people down? Because I find out that when you do that, it catches up with you after a while.
Amen.
Hey! Hallelujah!
Amen.
Hey!
Don't we be?
Hallelujah!
Amen.
See, words are power. What defile? See, I want you to understand.
Yes.
When God dealt with Pharaoh,
yes,
I show you how God dealt with him. He made a decree about how he was going to destroy the firstborn of Israel. What did God do? God sent the death angel,
amen,
the last of the 10 plagues.
Yes.
And he said, guess what? I'm going to turn your words against you.
Yes.
Because what has come out of your mouth has defiled you. Yes. Amen. And you're going to be subject to my judgment.
Hey,
my God.
Amen.
God turned around what he said.
Yes, he did.
Amen.
See, if he didn't say that in the first place, make that decree,
yes. He
might have stayed out of that trouble.
Yes.
Maybe that wasn't the way, but what happened was that when he made a decree, God said, because what has come out of your mouth has defiled you. When you go against the word of God,
well,
and you speak against the word of God, it defiles you.
Yes, it does.
Amen.
When the Israelites were right there, edge of the promised land,
yeah. The
thing that said, the reason why their, amen, their diagnosis or their review or whatever of the promised land was given an evil report.
Yes.
What it did was it defiled.
Yes.
They defiled themselves by saying that. Why? Because they spoke against God. Did not God promise them a land flowing with milk and honey?
That's right.
Did they not bring back even evidence?
Yes. Isn't that something?
Amen. That it was as the Lord had told them.
Amen.
Yet still, they would not believe. So because they said the people are too big, the land is too vast, we can't do it. What came out of their mouth, they defiled themselves with unbelief.
Amen.
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 The Pharisees defiled themselves with unbelief,
yes,
because of the things that they said about Jesus,
yes,
and their reaction to him. And today this world continues to defile itself because of the things that come out of their mouth, because of their unbelief.
Amen.
Amen. If you look in the 7th verse of Mark, so what defiles a man? Amen. And it reads, then came together unto him the Pharisees, a certain of scribes, which came from Jerusalem. And when they had saw some of his disciples eat bread with defiled, amen, that is to say, with unwashed hands, they found fault. For the Pharisees and all the Jews, except that they washed their hands off, eat not, holding the tradition of the elders. And when they came from the market, except they washed, they ate not. And many other things there be, which they have received to hold, as the washing of cups, pots, brazen vessels, and tables. They were into the ritual,
oh, yeah,
and not the reality.
Amen.
Amen. They were worried about the outward appearance. Some people, when they come to church on Sunday, they're all dressed up. They took a shower. They took a bath. They got all the perfume. Their clothes are impeccable, but they're dirty as dogs. Hey! Amen. Hallelujah! Because they were holy. Pharisees, scribes, asked him, why walk not thy disciples according to the tradition of elders, but eat bread with unwashed hands?
Yes.
And he answered and said unto him, mm-hmm, well have the disciples prophesied of you hypocrites, as it is written, these people honor me, mm-hmm, with their lips, but their heart is far from me. See, God works on the inside.
Amen.
God see.
Yeah.
Amen. I often say that you can tell the people that go, don't come to church, tell the brothers that don't come to church very often, because many times their suits are impeccable. Amen. They don't got nothing on them. Amen. Everything is impeccable.
Yeah.
They haven't been coming to church. They haven't been wearing the same suits. They haven't been faithful. So the one time they come, everything is in place. So they give the appearance of everything being all right, but in their heart, on the inside, they have defiled God.
Amen.
By what comes out of their mouth.
Amen.
And by the way that they live.
Yes.
It's what's on the inside.
Amen.
We often worry about putting stuff in our mouth, but God said, what's on the inside, what comes out from within,
yes,
is what defiles a man.
Amen. Amen.
How be it in vain do they worship me,
vain,
teaching for doctrines and commandments of men?
Mm.
For laying aside the commandment of God, ye hold the tradition of men, as in the washing of pots and cups, and many other such things do ye.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And he said unto them, Full well you reject the commandment of God, that you keep your own tradition. Amen. You can talk about it all you want, you can keep, let me tell you. The Catholics have many rituals.
Yes, they do.
They got many rituals. Certain things they won't do. Amen?
Amen.
But if they don't change their doctrine, hey! If they don't change what they teach and preach and live,
Hallelujah.
In hell, they
won't
live up there.
Hallelujah.
Amen?
Amen.
Yes, true.
The Hindu got many rituals.
That's true.
But they're still in spiritual doctrine.
That's right.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Muslims have many rituals.
That's right.
Yes.
But they're still in spiritual darkness.
Yes.
And ironically enough, apostolic folks got some rituals.
That's true.
Yes.
That's true.
And they're still
in
darkness. Now they've been told the truth.
Right.
But they're still in darkness.
Amen.
And this is evidenced by their reaction.
That's right, go ahead.
To the truth.
That's right.
Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. But they did not believe him.
That's right.
Amen?
Amen.
They did not believe, and because they doubted him, every time they spoke against them, they defiled themselves.
Amen.
They put judgment on their own self. Every time we deny the living God, we defile ourselves. Every time somebody says, I'm offended by the gospel, they defile themselves. What comes out of their mouth has defiled them. Don't let nobody fool you. They're going to have to give an account. The Bible says, for every idle word. It didn't say because you ate a roast beef sandwich. It didn't say because you ate peanut butter and jelly. But it said every idle word that came out of your mouth. You're going to have to give an account for all. When you spoke against somebody, hallelujah, when you tore them down, you're going to have to give an account for that which you said.
Amen.
Hey! God said it's 2050. It's time to give that up.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
They rejected Jesus.
Yes.
See, when you start trembling, when you tear people down, you're a hypocrite.
Okay.
Well,
and you defile your own self.
That's amen.
Right.
You defile your own self.
Yes.
God is saying it's time to stop tearing one another down.
Amen.
Now, if you say this, if you got the Holy Ghost, sometimes you know what some of us need to do? We need to go to God and say, Lord, I know I got a big mouth, Lord. I know I like to gossip, but Lord, help me.
Amen.
That's right.
Lord, I know I like to gossip. Lord, I know it's a weakness. Lord, I really don't intend to hurt nobody, but Lord, sometimes I have a big mouth. Lord, help me.
Amen.
Yes.
Help me, Lord, because I want to make it to heaven.
Yes.
And I don't want to be a stumbling block to anybody else getting to heaven.
That's true.
That's right.
Be honest with God. You know
that's
what God will do?
Yeah.
God will show more mercy to you than you've shown to other people.
Amen.
Yes.
Because that's the kind of God that we serve.
Yes.
If you were just come, that's why the word has come. Let us reason.
That's right.
Together.
Amen.
God said, come. He said, this said, come, let me chop your head off.
Right.
Let me put my foot on your neck.
Thank you.
God is not like that.
Not
He's merciful.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm not going to put anything over on God. No. You're not going to put anything on. Might as well, Lord, this is who I am.
Amen.
Help me.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
This is who I am, Lord. Help me. I want to make it.
Amen.
I want to do right.
Amen.
Help me, Lord, to make it.
Amen.
Lord, I got a weakness.
Oh, yeah.
And I need help.
Amen.
Sometimes what come out of my mouth is not right.
Yes. Amen.
Sometimes what come out of my mouth is not right.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Yes, sir. That's right.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
You gotta ask, is what? Amen. Is what a person comes out of your mouth?
Yes.
That defiles you.
Yes. Yes.
People don't understand it.
Amen.
They're worried, you know, they go to the gym and they work on themselves. And one thing I could see, if we had the makeup of people in church. Like we got in the gym, true. It would be a beautiful thing.
Amen. So true.
You go to the gym, it's black and white.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Amen.
Male and female, uh-huh. Rich, poor.
Uh-huh.
Young and old.
Go ahead.
Amen. Amen. You see these brothers over there about 80 years old, they get on their side.
That's true.
Everybody
Amen.
Is interested
yes.
in the outward appearance.
Amen.
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 If we could get people more interested what's on the inside,
Amen.
It would really be something.
Amen.
LeBron said, Lord, if we could get all these people in church,
wow. yes.
it'd be something. If we could get all these people to give their life to you, we could
Amen.
Get them saved.
Amen.
It would. We would really. Really have something even greater.
Amen.
Amen.
Lord, I thank you for what we have, but Lord, if we,
you, Lord.
Amen, could get these people to really believe, Lord,
yes.
and understand what time it is.
Hallelujah.
But so many people are worried about the outward appearance.
Yes.
We take so much time working on the outward appearance.
Yes.
Rather, we got to worry about what's on the inside.
That's right.
Help, Amen. That's why David said, creating me what? A clean heart.
Amen.
David didn't say, well, my reputation is ruined now. Help me, Lord, to restore my reputation. No, David knew he was a dirty
That's
dog.
Right. Amen.
Amen. He
Lord,
said, I'm guilty, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
I've done wrong.
Yes.
I'm wrong every which way.
Yes.
Amen. Some of you will never say that to God.
Amen.
Some of you will never. It's Lord. Always someone else.
Amen.
When is it going to be you?
Help us, Lord.
When is it going to be me?
Well,
when is it? It's always somebody else's fault.
That's
yes.
true.
You're never wrong.
Amen.
God can't work with a person that's never wrong. Do you
Amen.
Realize that? God can't do nothing for a person that's never wrong.
That's Amen. Right.
Because the fact that you feel that way makes you wrong in the first place.
Amen.
That's why the Bible said, come now, let us reason together.
Amen.
Understand what God is trying to do. He's not trying to kill you. He's trying to help you.
Yes,
he loves you so
yes,
much
yes.
that he wants you to be right and do right.
Amen.
But if you can, if we continue
yes,
to knock each other down.
Mm-hmm.
In the book of Proverbs, the 15th chapter said, a soft anger turneth away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger. The tongue of the wise useth knowledge aright, but the mouth of fools poureth out foolishness.
Well,
you can say what you, oh, I have to tell it.
Oh my.
I had to tell it.
Uh-oh.
I couldn't stand it, but I had to tell it. That's how some of you are.
Yeah.
I had to tell it. No, sometimes I have to step back.
That's right. That's true.
You know, David, he could have been like some of us.
Yes.
Well, he tried to kill me. I got him right here sleeping.
Mm-hmm.
Dead to right.
Yes,
time
right.
to get him back.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to get him back now. I'm going to draw him up and quarter yeah. him and do everything. I'm going to make pork chops out of him.
Oh, my.
Amen?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I'm going to take him to the butcher.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. David didn't do that.
That's right.
No, he didn't.
Amen. Joseph could have had that kind of attitude. Well, listen. Joseph could have said to his brothers, how you like me now?
Uh-huh.
You put me in that hole,
oh, yeah.
got sold to slavery, but how you like me now?
What?
Now who's the boss?
Oh yeah.
He didn't do that.
Thank God.
Well, good have.
Thank God.
Amen. Thank God.
He brought him into his inner chamber.
Thank
yes.
you, Lord.
And he wept.
Yes.
Because he loved them.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Because there was no bitterness in his heart.
Amen. Yes.
There was no get back spirit.
Amen.
And because he didn't have that, God blessed them. And we were talking about in the Sunday school. Let me
yes.
tell you, things are going to happen to you and me
yes.
that are not always fair.
That's right.
Amen?
That's
Amen.
Right.
Folks are going to talk about you.
Well,
it's not always fair.
That's right.
Folks are going to even say flat out lies.
Amen.
I'm talking about right in the church.
Amen.
Right in the church. That's right.
They're going to shout on Sunday morning
mm-hmm.
and talk you down
mm-hmm.
Sunday afternoon.
Yes, mm-hmm. they will.
But you don't have to be bitter and angry.
That's right.
You don't have to go to the
top.
That's right.
Why?
That's right.
Because in 2015, you want to be saved.
Amen.
Right.
You want to grow up in the Lord.
Yes.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
You want to grow up in the Lord. That's what you want to do.
Amen.
You don't want to stay the same way.
No.
You don't want to keep acting like children,
Amen.
Like babies, but you want to grow in the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
I want to show my brother and sister a different way.
Amen.
I want them to see that Christ is real.
Oh, yes.
I'm going to learn to use wisdom. I'm not going to run my mouth all the time.
That's right.
Amen. Now, sometimes you got to say something,
right.
but not all the time.
Amen.
You got to watch what you're saying.
That's
Amen.
Right.
Amen. It says, the eyes of the Lord are in every place, beholding the evil and the good. See, God sees you, know.
Amen.
Some people like to throw things out and then they watch the chaos.
Isn't that sad?
I'm saying, and you know what? They're saved and sanctified. No, that is of the devil.
It sure is.
They like to throw things out. They'll walk up to you, say something, and amen. That thing may crush you and keep on going.
Yeah, amen.
And then, amen, when you cry, you know what they'll say? See, I told you.
Mm-hmm.
They weren't saved.
Mm-hmm.
That's exactly what they'll do.
Amen.
That's of the devil. We need to cut that out.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. Time is winding up.
Yes.
I want you to understand, you're going to have to answer for everything. Some people think that because of the things that they do, and I said it in Amen for counsel,
yes.
they think that because they do things, they say things, mm-hmm. they turn people away mm-hmm. from wanting to follow God, mm-hmm. and because God don't knock them down, they think that it's on the back burner, that it's in the sea of forgetfulness, mm-hmm. but God said, not so.
Hallelujah.
You're going to have to give an account. Hallelujah. That thing is unresolved. Why is it unresolved? Because it keeps happening over and over again.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, God.
That's why God said
Jesus.
In the 25th chapter of Matthew, it said, depart from me, work of iniquity.
Amen.
That's right.
I know you're not.
Amen.
Amen. Some people work with the thing of iniquity.
Yes.
Amen. Sometimes we're all guilty of it.
Amen.
I'm speaking to everyone, including myself.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. We're all because we're human.
Amen.
We need to stop that. We need to let yes. people see that Christ is real because
yes.
He is.
Amen.
He is.
Yes, Amen. He is.
But people are only going to make a decision for the Lord if we're where we ought to be in Christ.
Amen.
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 If we're all guilty. Don't look at your brother and sister.
Amen.
Look, amen. If you had a mirror, I said, hold it up. Hold up the mirror.
That's
because
right.
Because we're all guilty.
Amen.
Amen.
You hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
Amen. We need to realize.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And it goes on to say in the 7th verse, the lips, amen, of the wise disperse knowledge,
yes.
but the heart of the foolish doeth not so. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The sack, amen. The way of the wicked is an abomination unto the Lord, but he loveth him that followeth after righteousness.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. So God, what is God saying? What God is saying is watch yourself.
Amen.
In 2015, let's grow up. Let's be real.
Amen.
Amen. Like I said before, those young people desiring to be married.
Yes.
Amen. Let's not talk about every imperfection.
That's right. That's right.
Well, they're not perfect, but guess what? Neither are you.
Well,
amen.
Neither am I.
Amen.
So when I got married, people predicted the demise.
That's so true.
It wouldn't last 6 months.
Oh, yeah.
It wouldn't last a year.
Amen.
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 But I knew there were some people that were yes. praying for
Thank you, Lord.
I knew Bishop Brown was praying for
Amen.
Us.
Amen.
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 Amen. Some of those people that talked about us aren't even in the church today. You know why? Because what they did finally caught up to them.
Yes.
And that's what it does. It catches up. See,
yes,
God gives you time and space for repentance.
Amen.
And sometimes we think at the end of our life, judgment will come. But judgment can come quicker than that.
Amen.
Sometimes we think, oh, we're going to be here when the Lord comes back. May it may not be
that's
so.
Right. That's right.
You may see eternity before the Lord comes back.
Right.
Amen.
Tomorrow's not promised to us.
No, it's not.
Amen. People that started out. Amen.
Amen.
And let me tell you, the famous and the infamous die.
That's
yes,
true.
Amen. So don't think, oh, well, only all the heathen. No. the saved and the unsaved, they pass.
Amen.
Amen. You hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
The saved and the unsaved, they pass.
Amen.
So it's important we got to be ready at all times.
All
times. That means you got to watch what you say. You got to understand.
Right.
Use wisdom. And if you don't, ask the Lord for some wisdom.
Amen.
If you got a weakness, Lord, say, here, Lord, this is my weakness.
Yeah.
Lord, help me, Lord, because I want to make it.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I want to make it to heaven, Lord. I want anything.
Amen.
Lord, not only that, Lord, I want to be uplifted. You know, we were taught back in old school teaching of children, they were taught, well, if you don't have anything nice to say,
mm-hmm.
that's right. Don't say anything at all.
Amen.
I try to keep that. I'm not going to tell, you're great, you're wonderful, if I think you're a bum.
That's right. That's right.
I ain't going to say that.
Amen.
I just won't say anything.
That's right.
If they ask me, I say, well, you asked for it.
Well, yes. That's right.
That's right. And I wouldn't call them a bum.
Thank God.
I say, you know, there's a situation, brother.
That's right.
There's a situation, sister.
That's
in
right.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 And I try to do it in a nice, loving way, but let them know what does say the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
So it's important for us as we grow into this year. God wants you to be different.
Yes.
God wants you to be. God wants you to stop the backbite. Backbite talk is cheap.
Yes, it is.
Talk is cheap.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Talk is cheap.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. One of the things I appreciate about Mother Parks is that the fact that she's not a great talker,
amen.
But when she says something, it makes sense.
Oh yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
And she's usually right.
Amen.
She's more what I call a doer. A lot of women are talkers.
Oh yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Like somebody said, amen, that you know, most men experience, amen, hearing loss between the ages of 19 and 45. They said, well, that's about the time to get married.
Amen. Amen. That's right. Amen.
Amen. You know, those are the ones that are smart, because you don't want to end up in jail.
Amen.
Amen. You go for a walk and tune it out so that you don't get all upset and then you do something you regret.
Yeah,
amen.
Amen.
But thank God, she's what I call a doer. Not a great talker, but she's a doer.
Amen.
She knows how to, by the grace of God, she accomplished things.
Amen.
A lot of these women, they'll talk,
mm-hmm.
and don't get nothing done.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Amen.
A lot of men are like that. They'll talk, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna remember it. Told you about the brother with the name, I'm gonna do this, I'ma do that, that's how some of us are. We gonna do, no, don't talk so much.
Amen.
Just do.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
And then when you finish, you know what? The glory belongs to God.
That's right. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.